Next, the fifth subdivision, a lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days and an additional charge for each day thereafter. Okay, so for the first 3 days, the book we are lending, we have to pay some fixed charge. Then after that 3 day ends, we have to pay a certain amount for each extra day. Okay, so Sarita paid ₹27 for a book she kept for 7 days. Okay, then Susie paid ₹21 for the book she kept for only 5 days. Okay, then we have to find the fixed charge and the charge for the each extra day. Okay, so let's move for the solution. We have to find two things, the fixed charge and the charge for each extra day. So we do not know both the things, so let the fixed charge be ₹X. Okay, let the charge for each extra day be Y. Okay, in this problem there are two characters, one is Sarita and another one is Susie, right? So we are going to represent the given data with the help of a tabular column. Okay, so let me write the amount paid by Sarita, then the amount paid by Susie. Okay, in columns I am going to fill it with the fixed charge, then extra amount for extra days, then the total amount. Okay, see here, the Sarita has to pay a fixed charge for the first 3 days. So they have given the fixed charge for the first 3 days to be X, right? So it is X. Then the amount, the fixed charge paid by Susie for the first 3 days will be X, right? So the fixed charge is X in both the scenarios. Okay, then see here, Sarita has paid ₹27 for the book she kept for 7 days. So she is keeping a book for 7 days. So she has paid rupees X for the first 3 days. So the remaining will be 4 days. So 7 minus 3 gives 4. Already she had paid X rupees for the first 3 days. Then for the remaining 4 days, she has to pay rupees Y for each day, right? So 4 into Y rupees. Okay, so which is 4Y. Okay, the extra amount the Sarita has to pay is 4y. Then in Susie's condition, she is keeping a book for 5 days. Okay, so already she had paid a fixed charge for the first 3 days she has kept, then the remaining days are 2. 5 minus 3 gives 2. So the extra, for the extra 2 days, she has to pay 2 into y rupees, that is 2y rupees. Clear? Because for extra each day they are charging Y rupees. Okay, Sarita is having the book for extra 4 days, so she is paying 4Y rupees. Then Susie is having the book for extra 2 days, so she is paying an extra amount of 2Y rupees. Already they have paid X rupees as fixed charge. So the total amount paid by Sarita, okay, it is fixed charge plus the extra amount for extra days. So it is X plus 4Y. Clear? Then the total amount paid by Susie, it is fixed charge plus the extra amount for extra days. So it is X plus 2Y. Clear? The amount paid by Sarita is X plus 4Y. The amount paid by Susie is X plus 2Y. Okay? So she has kept the book for 7 days and paid rupees X plus 4Y rupees. Then Susie has kept the book for 5 days and she has paid x plus 2y rupees. Clear? So according to the given condition, we can frame the equations as x plus 4y is equal to the amount paid by Sarita, which is 27. Amount paid by Sarita, we can equate this expression to 27. Clear? Then the amount paid by Susi, x plus 2y. In the problem they have given, it is 21 rupees. So we can equate x plus 2y to 21. Okay? So these are the two equations we have framed. Equation number 1, equation number 2. Okay? So by elimination method we are going to solve these equations. See here, already the x coefficients are numerically same. Okay? So we are going to just subtract the equation number 2 from 1. So subtracting 2 from 1. So it will be x plus 4y is equal to 27, then x plus 2y is equal to 21. Subtracting both the equations, we have to change the signs of the second equation. It become minus x, it will become minus 2y, then it will become minus 21. X minus x, it will be cancelled, then 4y minus 2y gives plus 2y, then 27 minus 21 gives 6. So we have got the value of y to be 3, because 2y is equal to 6. When I take this 2 to right side, it becomes by 2. So y is equal to 6 by 2, which implies y is equal to 3. Okay. Now substituting y is equal to 3 in second equation. So it is x plus 2y, that is 2 into 3 is equal to 21. So x plus 6 is equal to 21. So x is equal to 21 minus 6. So the value of x is 15. Thus we have obtained the values for x and y. Now we are going to give the conclusion for this subdivision. We have assumed the fixed charge to be x rupees. So the fixed charge is rupees, the x value 15. Clear? Then the charge for each extra day is, we have assumed this data to be y, right? So the value of y here is 3. So it is 3 rupees. Thus the fixed charge is rupees 15 and the charge for extra day is rupees 3. Clear?